Hello, I take this opportunity to thank you all for visiting and sharing our educational channel. Today I have case study number 12 for you. It is taken from first 500 COVID-19 cases. 20% of the cases showed decreased levels of white blood cells, lymphocytes and platelets, and increase in prothrombin time and D-dimer. I have presented one case from these 20% cases with clinical significance of various laboratory tests. A 65-year man presented with high fever, headache, chest pain, shortness of breath and muscle weakness. With reference to COVID-19 pandemic, he was advised COVID-19 ELISA test on his nasopharyngeal swab, and the test was positive and it was confirmed by RT-PCR test, and diagnosis was patient was suffering from COVID-19. To study the prognosis of the disease, his blood was collected for various tests. First, we will discuss his complete hemogram report. From the complete hemogram report on the left-hand side, the observation was his total white blood cells were decreased, lymphocytes were decreased, total number of platelets were decreased, and there was increase in neutrophils and the ratio of neutrophil to lymphocyte. The presumption was possibility of COVID-19 infection of hematopoietic cells, the stem cells that produce blood cells. Hence, there was reduction in leukocytes at that particular stage and increased ratio of neutrophils to lymphocytes, NLR, usually indicate poor prognosis. Now we will discuss blood coagulation test reports. His prothrombin time was increased and D-dimer values also were increased. Probably COVID-19 induces development of autoimmune antibodies or immune complexes that play significant role in inducing thrombocytopenia, that means decreasing platelet count. Increased D-dimer indicate the presence of abnormally high levels of fibrin degradation products, probably due to disseminated intravascular coagulation, DIC. And prothrombin time also increases in DIC. One critical mediator of DIC is tissue factor, TF, which is present in high concentration in lungs, and due to lung tissue damage, TF is released in high concentration that leads to DIC. Lung tissue contains high concentration of the enzymes SGOT and LDH. Hence, in lung tissue damage, in infection, these enzymes increase in blood, and the levels of these both enzymes SGOT and LDH indicate the severity of lung disease. Similarly, the inflammatory markers procalcitonin and C-reactive protein increase in blood circulation in tissue damage due to increase in number of tissue degradation factors, and hence high levels of these tests indicate severe lung disease. Troponin T and troponin I increase in blood circulation following heart tissue damage. In the case of this patient, normal levels of troponin T and troponin I indicate that heart of this patient was not probably affected by COVID-19 infection. Well, when we look back at the symptoms of this patient, you will realize that fever is a protective response to injury and infection. An elevated temperature of the body increases innate defense mechanisms and make conditions less favorable for infectious microorganisms to grow in the body. And dry cough and chest pain was due to lung disease caused by COVID-19 infection. Shortness of breath was due to significant fluids accumulated in the lungs by high levels of various cytokines induced by lymphocyte defense mechanisms. I thank you once again for your support to our educational channel. Kindly share our videos with your all contacts. Next time, I will present case study number 13 of COVID-19 case suffering from respiratory acidosis.